203.1. Now that the 115 contamination of the Red Army is complete, the Valkyrie drones have been programmed to probe the ruins of the city. They will find any resistance trains and attempt capture. As directed by Dr. Groff, I have updated Valkyrie 7 and 8 to penetrate enemy lines in an effort to secure any survivors for study. Regrettably, however, contact with Valkyrie 8 was lost after it engaged one of the targets. Directive log 203.2. Specimen 33 is no longer responding to recall frequencies with 100% consistency. It is essential that this behavior is corrected before Dr. Groff's inspection of our forward hatchery next week. I have made several frequency adjustments that I believe may correct the undesired behavior. Commencing test. Imprinting frequency modification. All personnel, evacuate the area. Directive log 223.1. Though it appears to be a slightly inferior copy of the German Riese model, the Russian Gigant robot has proven to be a formidable unit. Unlike the Riese, the Gigant is armed with a high-energy beam weapon fired from the cranial dome. Like the Riese, its highly durable construction means it can withstand most conventional attacks. However, the robot was never designed to withstand dragon attacks, leaving it extremely vulnerable to their fire. Directive log 240.2. Though German Dragon units have proven devastating to the Russian ground forces, the enemy have nonetheless found a weakness to exploit. A prototype weapon known as the Asalon Lance uses 115 charged rounds to weaken and penetrate their hide. The Russians have been quick to retrofit this new weapon onto their surviving mech units. Directive log 272.5. Intelligence confirms that Project Rasputin has yielded the creation of a new enemy type we have not seen before. Dubbed the Russian Mangler Soldier, these units are equipped with high-caliber armament that has proven highly effective against our ground units. Their shockwave attack disrupts movement across a large area, even when our troops are hiding in cover. Additionally, their strong armor plating has proven highly durable to conventional attacks. However, these enhanced combat abilities come at a cost. Their relatively slow speed leaves them vulnerable to being outmaneuvered by the enemy, particularly when significantly outnumbered. Additional vulnerability comes from the unit's cannon, which is prone to explode when fire is focused upon its power regulator.